Just how close have we come to the apocalypse? A lot more than you might imagine. Just between the years 1950 and 1980 alone, the United States experienced a reported 32 accidents involving nuclear weapons. That is according to journalist Eric Schlosser, who has documented the many times we've come close to Code Red in his book Command and Control.
Well, there was one nuclear weapons accident in 1961 over North Carolina, where a B-52 bomber started to break apart midair because there was a fuel imbalance in the plane. And as it was breaking apart, the fuselage started to spin. And the centrifugal forces on the plane as it was breaking apart pulled a lanyard in the cockpit. And that was the lanyard that a crew member would pull if they were over the Soviet Union, about to bomb the Soviet Union. There were two hydrogen bombs on the plane, and hydrogen bombs are dumb. They're machines. And when that lanyard got pulled, the bombs didn't know they were over North Carolina, not over Moscow. And one of the bombs went through all of its arming steps. And when it hit the ground, there was a firing signal sent. And there was only one switch inside the bomb that prevented a full-scale detonation. And that would have been a bummer, because John F. Kennedy had just become president, and they literally would have had to evacuate Washington, D.C. The difference between safety and catastrophe was one switch. Now, this particular switch, the following year, was found to be defective in many of our nuclear weapons. They would unload the weapons from the airplane and realize that the weapons were fully armed because the switch hadn't worked. If one of the defective switches had been in that bomb, it just sounds so corny, but it would have changed the course of history. Again and again, you find examples, hundreds, if not a thousand or more accidents involving our nuclear weapons that could have ended very badly.
The direction which military history has gone since the end of the Cold War has been to very targeted kinds of warfare. We're talking about drone warfare. Yeah. And no one's suggesting the drones are perfect, they are certainly not, but it's a much more surgical approach to modern warfare. And in that sense, nuclear weapons don't seem to necessarily fit that trend. Do you think nuclear weapons still have a role to play in keeping the world safe? That idea of mutually assured destruction, does it still apply in 2015?
You know, I think it's more complex. I think that the threat to kill all the civilians of your enemy country, it is effective. But at the same time, it's a psychological threat. And if you get a madman as a leader, or if you have a group like ISIS or Al-Qaeda, that believes that dying on behalf of a cause sends you to heaven, then threatening to kill doesn't have that impact. So I think in the 21st century, nuclear weapons have no purpose whatsoever. And this summer is the 70th anniversary of the destruction of Hiroshima. And that was a really crude, inefficient, rudimentary nuclear weapon. And in an instant, it killed 80,000 people and knocked down two-thirds of the buildings in a big city. Now, we built in the Cold War nuclear weapons 1,000 times more powerful than that. The nuclear weapons that Russia, the United States, China, France, Great Britain has are vastly more powerful than that. So I think, you know, everyone has to realize that we either work towards reducing the number of these things and eliminating them, or there are going to be catastrophes that make 9/11. I was in New York City on 9/11, and I saw, you know, the aftermath of the destruction of the World Trade Center. That will seem trivial compared to what's possible with these weapons.
We all know the atomic bomb is very dangerous, and that means duck and cover fast wherever you are.
Can you ever see a future where we are disarmed, or is it just too hard, too complicated, difficult politically, difficult practically?
I think it's within our power, if not to solve it 100%, to greatly reduce the danger. And the first step is for people to be aware. These nuclear weapons are out of sight, out of mind, literally. I mean, you know, they're in silos underground, they're in submarines under the surface, but there are these machines waiting to kill you. It's as simple as that. There's still 16,000 nuclear weapons in the world. They're wired up, they're ready to go, And if one of them goes off, it's going to be a catastrophe just beyond description.